We have seen some of the examples of chemical change. We'll see some activities, how what changes takes place and how the reactions takes place between any two reactants. We'll see one activity. Further, what are the materials required? We need one beaker, calcium oxide. This calcium oxide is also known as quicklime, and water. So these are the three materials required for this activity. First, take one beaker, add 1 gram of calcium oxide to the beaker, and then pour 10 ml of water. Pour 10 ml of water to the beaker. So what happens? Water like this. This calcium oxide dissolves in water. Okay, now and when we observe, this calcium oxide dissolves in water, and there is a reaction between calcium oxide and water. So when we observe this beaker, when we touch this beaker, it becomes hot. It means heat is released in this reaction. When calcium oxide reacts with water, heat is released, so that when we touch this beaker, the heat is released. It means this is exothermic reaction. In any reaction, when heat is released, that reaction is called exothermic reaction. So reaction of calcium oxide with water is an example of exothermic reaction. So in this reaction, when calcium oxide reacts with water, it forms calcium oxide. When calcium oxide reacts with water, it forms calcium hydroxide. This calcium hydroxide is a basic in nature. Then we can test whether it is an acid or base with the help of litmus paper. With the help of litmus paper, we can test whether it is an acid or base. When this red litmus, when red litmus paper is kept in this solution, this red litmus paper changes to blue litmus. Red litmus paper changes to blue litmus. It means it is a base. So the calcium oxide, which is formed after the reaction of calcium oxide with water, is a basic in nature. Stop. We'll see one more activity. For that, materials required are 2 beakers and water and barium chloride and sodium sulfate. Barium chloride and sodium sulfate chemicals. So these are the materials required for this activity. First, take one beaker, fill it with 100 ml of water. Fill it with 100 ml of water, and then add barium chloride, few amount of barium chloride to the water. Assume that this is water, and add barium chloride to that water. Then we get barium chloride solution. We get barium chloride solution, which is colorless. Next, take one more beaker, add about 100 ml of water. Add 100 ml of water, and then add sodium sulfate. Sodium, few amount of sodium sulfate to the beaker, and then this sodium sulfate dissolves in water and forms sodium sulfate solution. Sodium sulfate solution. Here we got barium chloride solution and sodium sulfate solution. So if we add these two, solutions, that is barium chloride solution and sodium sulfate solution, there is a reaction. So we are adding barium chloride to the sodium sulfate solution. When barium chloride reacts with sodium sulfate, it forms sodium chloride and barium sulfate. Sodium chloride and barium sulfate solution is formed. So this is one more reaction between some reactants, barium chloride and sodium sulfate. Here we get sodium chloride and barium sulfate. Okay, we'll see one more activity, 3. For this, the materials required are conical flask, zinc granules, and hydrochloric acid. These are the 3 materials required for this activity. First, take one conical flask. Okay, now add hydrochloric acid to the conical flask and then add few zinc granules to the hydrochloric acid. Then what happens? This zinc reacts with the hydrochloric acid, and if we touch this conical flask, it becomes hot. It means when the zinc reacts with the hydrochloric acid, the heat is liberated. It means it is an example of exothermic reaction. Reaction of zinc with hydrochloric acid is an example of exothermic reaction. It means heat is evolved in this reaction. Next, when this zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid, some gas is released. Gas is released in this reaction. Then we have to test what gas is released in this reaction. The test for this gas is, take one matchstick. Take one matchstick and burn it and bring it to the mouth of the conical flask. When this gas is released, the matchstick fire will stop with the pop sound. It stops with the pop sound. This is the test for hydrogen. It means when zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid, the gas released is hydrogen and it also forms zinc chloride, ZnCl2. So this is the reaction when zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid. So hydrogen gas is released in this reaction. To test hydrogen gas, bring matchstick to the mouth of the conical flask, then the matchstick will stop with the pop sound. That is a test for hydrogen. So by these 3 activities, we can say that there are some changes in reactants. Based on the above 3 activities, we can conclude that if we observe these 3 reactions, in the first one, when calcium oxide reacts with water, it forms calcium hydroxide. In this reaction, reactants are the original reactants are different from products. So this is the first change. Original reactants are different from the products. It means new products are formed. And coming to second one, sodium sulfate reacts with barium chloride. It forms sodium chloride and barium sulfate. Here precipitate is formed. It means in some reactions precipitates are formed, which are insoluble in water. When compared to third one, when zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid, it forms zinc chloride plus hydrogen. So in this reaction, gas is evolved, and in some reaction precipitates are formed, and some reactions heat is released. It means some are exothermic reactions, and in some reactions heat is absorbed. They are called endothermic reactions. If some reactions need energy to react, it means some of the reactants do not react with each other, they need some heat. It means they absorb heat. That type of chemical reactions are called endothermic reactions. So based on the above activities, we can say that some of the original reactant is different from the newly formed compound. Precipitates are formed and gas is evolved in some reactions and heat is evolved in some reactions, that is exothermic or some endothermic reactions are formed. So like this we can say that based on the above activities there are some changes, that is chemical changes. These are all chemical changes.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel.